Hi guys, this is Aikya. Welcome back to my channel. I wanted to make a video on dupes today, and that's what this is going to be all about. When I started YouTube first, when I first got into YouTube, not making videos, but watching videos, I used to love watching dupe videos. I loved finding dupes of a lot of lipsticks and high-end products. If you've watched any of my, if you've read my blogs in the past, you know that I really love finding MAC lipstick dupes and stuff like that. And that sort of did fade away, but then, posting about it faded away, but then I never really stopped finding dupes and loving finding dupes. So I thought, I have a few products over here in front of me that I thought are pretty similar to their high-end counterparts. So I just wanted you guys to know about it. I wanted to let you guys in on my finds, which is why I'm making this video. But before we get into this video, I want to tell you guys that I post a new video every single Saturday. As of now, it's going to change. I'm going to start posting twice a week again very soon. And I'll be posting every Wednesday and Saturday then. But I should let you guys know of the new schedule when I actually start doing it. And please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'm going to leave a subscribe button right here, right here. So I just wanted to start off by telling you guys that these things that I have in front of me are not exactly 100% the same things. These are very similar things. These are like 9.5 and 10, like that different. But I thought that these guys were pretty close, and I really wanted you guys to know about all of this. So I'm just going to get into it in no particular order. I just have a few lipsticks over here, some blush and something very interesting, which I'm going to talk about in the end because it's my latest find, and that is pretty much the reason why I'm making this video. Without further ado, let's get into it. So the first thing I want to talk to you guys about is this MAC lipstick called Relentlessly Red. This is an extremely popular MAC lipstick. A lot of people love it, but it's a very different color. It is a little coral, it is a little pink, it is a little orange, and it is really, really red too. It is very similar to MAC's Impassioned. This is just a retro matte formulation. So something that I found very similar to this is this sleek lipstick in the shade Heartbreaker. I believe there's another sleek lipstick that I'm going to find the name of and link it down in the description box below. That is also going to be extremely similar. I don't have that lipstick, so I haven't swatched them side by side. I don't know. But of the swatches I've seen online, I know that it's going to be very, very similar. So the second lipstick I'm going to talk about is one of my favorite MAC lipsticks ever. This is MAC's Meher. It's one of the most beautiful neutral lipsticks for Indian skin tones, in my opinion. It has the right amount of cool tone in it, and it's going to be quite ironic I'm saying this because the next lipstick I show you is definitely a lot cooler than this, and it's definitely not going to suit a lot of us brown girls, and it's not really going to suit a lot of us over a lot of different skin tones, in my opinion, because it can pull a little gray. But if you're anywhere near my skin tone, and I'm so sorry that the light is completely washing me out, I'm unable to adjust it for some reason. It's a very gloomy day, but for some reason there's a lot of light coming through this window and I'm unable to adjust it, so I'm not as white as you can see in the camera over here. I'm around NC37 in MAC, and yeah, so if you're anywhere around my skin tone or lighter, I think this lipstick is going to look really nice on you. I think a little darker it's going to look pretty good too, but I think on more warm skin tone people like us, I don't know how it's going to look. I just can't picturize it for some reason. I'm really sorry, so please just look at it over here and be a judge for yourself. And the next lipstick I'm going to talk about is not really very expensive, so you can probably try it out in the store or whatever and then you'll know anyway. MAC Meher is, while I think it is a nice, pretty cool toned pink for Indian skin tones, the other one, this is still warmer than the dupe I'm going to show you guys and talk to you guys about. And these lipsticks are more like brother sister. They are not exactly the same. And the second lipstick I'm going to talk to you guys about, the dupe, is this Maybelline Color Show Creamy Matte Lip Color in the shade Lively Violet. I don't think these are exact dupes of each other, but I think they're extremely similar anyway. This is a tad bit darker and this is a tad bit cooler. The third lipstick is another MAC lipstick, and I probably should stop doing this. This is something that I've spoken to This is something I've spoken about on my blog. So if you have read my blog, you know what I'm going to talk about. But no other dupe is repeated from my blog. So please feel free to go check my blog posts out on my MAC Lipstick Dupes. The different blog posts, and I have not really compiled them anywhere. I think I'm going to compile a blog post, or maybe I'll do a YouTube video. I don't know. Let me think about it. But this is something that I've recently spoken about on my blog. It's probably on the first page of my blog or the second. And yeah, so if you've read it, you know that I'm going to talk about MAC's All Fired Up lipstick. And MAC's All Fired Up is a beautiful pinky red deep lipstick. It's bound to suit every single skin tone, in my opinion. It looks stunning on every single person, but that's probably because I love it so much. And I think a very close dupe of that is the Maybelline Lip Gradation in Pink 2. It's definitely a little deeper than MAC's All Fired Up, but I think it looks amazing. And I think on lips, they look so similar, you can't really tell the difference. The next dupe I'm going to talk to you guys about is of this beautiful Lancome lipstick. This is in the shade 322M, and it's called Corel in Love or something like that. And I think it's a very beautiful, sort of sheer but coral lipstick. It's beautiful. It's very nude-ish coral on my skin tone, but I think it looks really nice. This is really long-lasting though. It's moisturizing, and I really liked wearing it through summer last year and this year also. It's extremely light on the lips, and I mean, that's about the formula, but the color, I think it's a beautiful nudie coral on me, on my skin tone. If you're lighter than me, I think it's going to look amazing on you. It might just wash out a little darker skin tones than me. I think sometimes it washes me out, but because it's a little sheer in its formula, I think it works really well for me. But the dupe is not really very sheer. It's a darker version. I mean, it's a more pigmented version of this. Of all the lipsticks I have in my collection, in my opinion, this Rimmel lipstick in shade 16, this is the Kate Moss collection, I think it comes really close to this Lancome one. The Lancome one is definitely a lot more peach, and the Rimmel one is a lot more pink. But on my lips, it looks the same, because obviously my lips are a lot more pigmented, and the color of my lips does, you know, alter the color of these two lipsticks. And on my lips, they look exactly the same, which is why I'm listing them as dupes over here. If you don't have pigmented lips, they probably are not dupes, so I'm really sorry about that. But I was extremely excited about this find, because this Lancome lipstick is definitely one of the more expensive lipsticks I have, and the Rimmel one is definitely one of the more inexpensive ones I have. So I want to talk to you guys about these. And yeah, that is it. So moving on to blushes, I think there are a lot of blushes that I found that are very similar to a lot of blushes. I mean, you know, you pretty much wear the same kind of colors, right? You have some dusty pinks, you have some rose colors, you have some peaches, some corals, and they're all pretty similar, because there are not so many options that you do with blushes. At least I don't. I pretty much stick to similar colors. So I just want to talk to you guys about a blush that I love most. As you can tell, this is my MAC's Flapa blush, and this is my favorite blush of all times. It's a beautiful satin blush. The formula is amazing. It's extremely soft, it's extremely pigmented, extremely long lasting, and I love the color. It's my wear with anything and it'll go with anything blush. I can close my eyes and wear this. I can wear it a little more intense when I want. I can wear it a little more sheer if I want, and it's always going to deliver. I love this color. I think it's an extremely beautiful color. So I was really excited to find that I had all this while a dupe of this particular blush that I thought I loved almost as much as this, but I just never realized that they were so similar in their pigmentation. And the blush I'm talking about is this NYX blush in the shade Mocha. I mean, the name does throw you off a little. It's called Mocha, but it's definitely a beautiful dusty coral pink blush, exactly like my MAC's Flapper, which I'm going to show you right here. Look at that. I think the MAC blush is definitely a tad bit brighter than the NYX one, but they look exactly the same on my cheeks. This is the MAC blush, this is the NYX blush. This, as you can tell, is a tad bit lighter and brighter. It's just seeming so much brighter over here than it does over here. And the same way on my cheeks, they look exactly the same, which is why I'm listing them as dupes, in my opinion. I'm really sorry if you're disappointed in this video because you don't think that they look exactly the same over here. But in my opinion, as long as they look the same on your face, it works, right? Last but not the least, I found something that is a very similar dupe of one of my favorite favorite beauty related items. And if you've been watching my channel at all, if you've watched like any, I mean, video that, you know, tells you anything about me, you know that I am extremely obsessed with perfumes. I love perfumes, and you know that my absolute favorite perfume of all times is this Dolce & Gabbana light blue perfume. I think it's one of the most beautiful smelling perfumes. I mean, a lot of people don't like it. It is a little sharp, it is a little tart, it's extremely citrusy and extremely fresh. This fragrance is beautiful in my opinion. I don't know, I love it so much. I mean, lately I am into those warm fuzzy scents as well. I really like the sweeter scents as well, which I never used to like initially, but nowadays I am a little more appreciative of various kinds of perfumes. But this is something that I used to wear. This was all I would wear at one point of time. Then came in Elizabeth Arden green tea, and a lot of other fragrances did follow, but this was the only fragrance that I seemed to like or wear at one point of time in life. And it's still one of my favorites. This hasn't gone anywhere, and this won't ever. I just hope that they never stop, you know, making this perfume up. But the only point is that this is an extremely expensive perfume. It's like, what, 5,500 to 5,000, like 6,000-ish, around that price range this is. And while I do get it on like most of my birthdays and stuff like that, my brother buys it for me for my birthday, and I'm not without this bottle ever. But every time I reach around this part of this bottle, it does hurt. Like, I feel bad. It physically pains for some reason, because I know that it's just not going to last a lot longer, and I need to shell out that much amount of money to get a new bottle of the same, and it's not a very nice thought. But recently I was at the Marks and Spencer store, and you know Marks and Spencer's have their own line of fragrances, right? So I was sniffing around a few things, and I didn't like so many of those the extremely floral ones. I didn't like those at all. But then I found a bottle, and it was this Autograph fragrance in Azure Breeze, and this is also an EDT. And when I sniffed this, I was in love, and I just knew that this was extremely similar to my D&G light blue. I mean, the bottle is pretty similar too. It's like a nice rectangular bottle, but obviously the cap is different. But it's this frosted white sort of a bottle too, as you can tell. I wish I could magically just spray this in my room here, and I wish you could smell these two perfumes, because you would know extremely... because then you would know how extremely similar these are. These are obviously not exactly the same. I'm going to list the notes and all of that of the D&G light blue down below, because I don't have an internet connection in this area. So while in my description box below, I will list list all the notes, top notes, base notes and middle notes or whatever of this perfume and this perfume. But because I have the bottle right here, I'm going to read out the notes of this fragrance. This is again an extremely light, I mean it's fresh, citrusy and zingy, but it's again very breezy. In my opinion, for some reason, this just seems a lot more concentrated. I mean, the D&G version seems a lot more concentrated than this. The only difference I find is that it's a lot more, like, it hits you harder. The D&G one is like a burst of something, and this is definitely slightly milder than that in my opinion. But then when I made somebody else sniff it, they said that this smelled a little orangey to them than this. I mean, what I think it meant was this was definitely a tad bit sweeter than this one. This was definitely more lemony, and this was a little more orangey, like it was slightly sweeter. But other than that, they're extremely similar as fragrances. This, unfortunately, I just sprayed it in my mouth. But unfortunately, this doesn't last on me as much. Or maybe it does. Maybe I just smell myself with it so much that at one point of time during the day, I can't smell this on me. Maybe it does last, I don't know, I can't tell. But in my opinion, I feel that the D&G one lasts a lot longer on me than the Marks and Spencer's one. But then this was just like 1500 rupees, and this is definitely my everyday scent now, because I love that so much. And that used to be my everyday scent, but now obviously I know I can't wear it every single day, because I'm going to run out of that bottle really soon. But because I love it so much, This is my everyday scent and I love it so much. Oh my god, I just had to tell you guys. I mean, I've barely had it for a week and I've already used up so much because I spray this all the time. So I'm anyway going to read out the notes. It says, opening with spicy ginger, crispy green apple and refreshing bergamot notes with a fruity heart and a beautiful rose, soft peach and orange flower scents. Resting on woody base aromas, the fresh fruity fragrance of Azure Breeze will awaken your senses. Basically, what I feel is the base notes are different because as this is going away on me, this still smells as the, you know, the top note smell. I mean, pretty similar. It stays throughout on me. But I think the base notes over here are a little different because as it fades on me, it smells extremely different, which is why I probably can't smell what I smelled initially on me, if I'm making any sense. Am I making any sense? I don't know. Please let me know in the comments below and I'll try to be a little more organized with my videos. I mean, where I'm speaking, I probably should have written all of this down. But I just wrote down topics about like, oh, MAC lipstick dupe, MAC blush dupe and D&G light blue dupe. This was it, guys. This was pretty much all of it that I want to talk about. I know it's probably not a lot, but I didn't want it to be a really long rambly video, which is why I just had a few products over here. If I find more things, I'm going to talk about more of them and I'm going to revisit my blog posts and see if those products that I spoke about as dupes are still dupes or if I found something better. And I'm going to let you guys know in my upcoming videos if I have found something better. If not, please check my blog posts out and you might find dupes of some amazing MAC lipsticks that you might appreciate. And this was it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.